Sarasati Devi Kauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschachati Satarine Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're hearing about the travels of Gop Kumar, a cowherd boy from Govardhan, who has a very powerful mantra, which takes him to the different places.
我们聆听到了，Gopal Kumar的历程，他是高尔丹山的一位牧牛童，他有了一首非常有力量的mantra，得以旅行到不同的地方。So
we heard how by the power of his mantra he was able to go into the region of liberation, which is beyond the material universe.
我们又听到了，就是他急着这首mantra，就旅行到了解脱之地，而这个地方是超越了物质的领域。So
while he was there, he met with a number of different people. He met with Lord Shiva and his associates, and then he also met with some people who had come from Vaikuntha.
当Gopal Kumar在解脱之地的时候，他遇到了几组人，一组人是Shiva和他的同游，另外一组人呢是Vaikuntha的居民。And
so they had some discussion about liberation, and the people from Vaikuntha were explaining the importance of performing Harinam Sankirtan. Harinam Sankirtan, meaning the congregational chanting of the holy names of the Lord.
Harinam Sankirtan. 意思就是齐颂主的圣名。Yeah.
So the people from Vaikuntha, they were telling Gop Kumar that by chanting the holy name of the Lord, they're able to actually bring the Lord into their association.
通过齐颂主的圣名，就可以把主邀请来，加入到他们的联谊当中。And
they told Gop Kumar that the chanting of the holy name is a better process than just sitting meditating on the Lord.
比单单的坐在那里冥想主要更好。When
you sit and meditate on the Lord, you may see the Lord in your heart.
当你坐下来开始冥想的时候，能够见到内心的主。But
by performing Sankirtan, we're able to see him and directly.
然而，通过齐颂主的时候，能够直接的看见主。And
that gives the greatest pleasure.
而直接看到主，能够给带给我们最高的、最大的快乐。So
the people from Vaikuntha, they were telling Gop Kumar that the goal of devotional service is that we want to actually see the Lord.
说到了，通过做奉献服务，目标就是实实在在的能够见到主。
And in Srimad Bhagavatam and other scriptures also, we hear about how devotees see the Lord.
在圣典博迦瓦坛以及其他的经典当中，我们聆听到，奉献者们是怎样能够直接的见到主。
Prahlad Maharaj, he was able to meet with Lord Nrsingadev.He didn't just see him in the heart. He actually directly met the Lord. He got mercy directly from Lord Nrsingadev.
Prahlad Maharaj 并不是说在心中见到了心中的主，而是面对面的，直接见到主Nrsingadev得到的他的仁慈。
And Kardama Muni also met the Lord.Kardama Muni, he was a great yogi. He was doing yoga for a long time. And the Lord came to him and told him, I'm sending you a girl. You take her for your wife.
Kardama Muni is a great yogi. But the Lord just came to find him.告诉他，我会给你派来一个姑娘，让她与你成亲。
And then after his marriage, Kardama Muni also got the Lord as his son. Lord Kapila came as his son.
而且婚后呢 ，Kardama Muni 也直接就得到了主作为自己的儿子 ，Kapila Muni.
Now.Gop Kumar had also heard about how Lord Brahma, he also got mercy from the Lord. Lord Brahma was doing meditation and he got mercy from the Lord.
Gop Kumar 也听说了主 Brahma 获得了主的仁慈。主 Brahma 在冥想当中，他坐在那里冥想，他获得了主的仁慈。
But the Lord directly appeared to Brahma and shook hands with him.
然而，主是直接的，就是面对面的来到了 Brahma 面前，并且跟他握手。
But that's very rare. The mercy which Lord Brahma got is very, it's only for very fortunate person like Brahma.
主这种仁慈呢是十分罕见的，他是非常幸运得到这种仁慈。
So the people from Vaikuntha are saying that having the vision directly seeing the Lord, this is the greatest pleasure.
Vaikuntha 的居民说道，就是拥有这种视力，能够直接的。见到主，这是人生最高的最大的快乐。
So, it's the same meditation or doing hearing and chanting devotional service gives the same result.
云明。Meditation and chanting and hearing is the same result?
Yeah, the result is to see the Lord.
Okay. 所以冥想和聆听以及唱诵这类奉献服务，他们是同样的结果，就是能够见到主。
Because when we're actually able to see the Lord, then we get rid of all the illusion of material life.
见到主的时候呢，我们就能够去除物质生活的种种幻觉。
So it's better to have the direct vision. that's better than just simply only meditating on him. And when we actually see him, then we won't forget him. Material world is all full of confusion, so many doubts. But when we see the Lord, then it's all clear, it's confirmed.
物质生活呢充满了迷惑，当我们能够面对面见亲眼见到主的时候，那这一切迷茫呢就都烟消云散了，而且我们所有的想也得到证实。Yeah,
when we actually see the beauty of the Lord, then our love, pure love, awakens from the heart. So we see like Prahlad Maharaj. Prahlad Maharaj, in the beginning, he was all, you know, he would only see the Lord in his heart. He was always remembering the Lord, but he didn't actually see him. And it wasn't until later, when Lord Nrsingadev appeared, that he actually saw him.
Prahlad Maharaj, 起初呢，只是在内心见到主，他只是得以能够一直不断的想着主，念着主，但是后来才见到了主，Nrsingadev。
So when he actually saw him, then he felt so much ecstasy.
只是在Prahlad Maharaj亲眼见到主Nrsingadev之后，他感到那么大狂喜。
When Prahlad Maharaj first saw Lord Nrsingadev, then that was his pure love awakened. Fully opened, fully developed.
当普拉玛拉智面对面看见主尼什哈德夫的时候，他的纯爱就得以全面绽放出来。Before
he was remembering him in the heart.
在此之前，普拉玛拉智只是在内心一直不断的意念着主。
But when he actually saw the Lord, then he felt so much ecstasy. So sometimes the devotee, sometimes when they're actually seeing Krishna, when they actually see him, sometimes they will close their eyes and it's like they're going into their mind. It seems to be meditation, but it's not.
有时候奉献者见到看见 Krishna 的时候呢，他们就会闭上双眼，就好像 Krishna 直接进入到他们的心意当中一样。这时候呢，看上去奉献者处在冥想当中，但实际上他们不是冥想。It's
a type. The closing of the eyes is like one of the ecstasies which they feel due to the great pleasure of seeing the Lord.
他们之所以闭上双眼呢，是因为内心因为亲眼见到主，感受到巨大的狂喜。Just
like when the four Kumaras, when they met the Lord in Vaikuntha, then they went into meditation. They went into a trance of meditation.
正如库马尔斯兄弟在Vaikuntha见到了主的时候呢，他们 就进入了 samadhi 神定，他们进入了一种冥想。
Yeah, and when they looked at the body of the Lord, then they were fully satisfied, and they just wanted to see him more and more.
当他们看见主的身躯的时候呢，他们全然的心满意足了，内心只想更多的能够去观察、观看主，注视着主。
So they began to meditate. They were meditating on the Lord very deeply.
因为他们想越来越多的能够看到主，所以他们就更加深入的开始冥想主。
But the Vaikuntha, people from Vaikuntha, they tell us that we shouldn't just look at the outward symptoms. Although they're closing their eyes, it's not that they're not seeing the Lord.
这些居民们告诉我们，我们不应当仅仅是看到这些人的他们的外在特征，他们闭上眼睛，并不是他们不想看见，他们没有看不看主，而是他们进入了这种深深的神定。Yeah,
they were not meditating. It was only the bhava, the awakening of devotional ecstasy. But it wasn't that they were meditating.
他们这时候不是处在冥想，并不是在冥想，他们是他们的巴巴，他们展示出了巴巴，他们奉献福的狂喜。So
they're pointing out, the Vaikuntha people are pointing out, it's better to see the Lord with the eyes. Don't just see him in the heart.
Vaikuntha 的居民就直接指出来。
So they. So when the Lord is not present, when he cannot be seen, then it's good to do meditation.
当主不在场的时候，就是没有机会见到主的时候呢，可以冥想的。But
if the Lord is present or not, we can always do Sankirtan. Sankirtan can be done in any situation. It's the best way to actually see him directly by chanting his holy name.
通过唱诵主的圣名，是能够直接的见到主最好的方法。We
see even the example of the gopis in Vrindavan, that they also do Sankirtan, and they chant his names, and when they're dancing with Krishna, when Rasa Lila, they're dancing with him and chanting his name.
在文达文的这些勾皮们，他们也 齐颂主的圣名，我们看到呢，他们在 Rasa 出当中呢，跟 Krishna 一起跳舞，他们也会齐颂圣名。Yeah,
gopis were chanting Krishna's names again and again, and they were at the same time they were seeing Krishna and dancing with them.
Gopis 们呢，他们会一而再、再而三的、反反复复的吟诵 Krishna 的名字。
And when Krishna left the gopis, then they were also chanting his name. When Krishna went away from them, Krishna hid himself from them. That time, then the gopis were all chanting Krishna's names. And after Krishna left Vrindavan to go to Mathura, then Uddhava came to visit the gopis. And Uddhava told them
Krishna.
Uddhava told them to chant the holy name. And the gopi said, we don't want to chant his name, but we can't stop chanting his name. So the Lord's holy name gives benefit to the whole world. There's nothing with so much nectar as the holy name. So performing Sankirtan is the best way to experience association with Krishna. Krishna is very beautiful and he's attracted by his own beauty, but he's more attracted by the chanting of the holy name. So Krishna's holy name blesses the world, gives a benediction to the whole world. Even if we're not qualified, but if we try to chant his holy name, we get a lot, so much benefit. It's so easy for us to worship Krishna by chanting his holy name. We just have to move the tongue. When we chant the holy name purely, then all the different rasa, all the different tastes for relationships with Krishna awaken. Devotees, when devotees do Sankirtan, then they experience the awakening of their love for Krishna. So the glories of Sankirtan is appreciated by all the great devotees. Even Lord Shiva also chants the holy name. And Lord Brahma also chants the holy name. So we're encouraged to also to follow their example, to absorb our mind in the chanting of the holy name and to taste the nectar of the name.
我们也受到鼓励要唱诵主的圣名，全然地专注于唱诵之中，并且去品味这种甘露。
So then the Vaikuntha Vasis, they told Gop Kumar that Lord Shiva's already told you that you should not stay here in this place, but you should go to Braja, you should go to Mathura.
不要待在这里，你应当去布拉扎，去马图拉。Yeah,
because Gop Kumar is in the place of liberation. It's the place of Sayujya Mukti, the place of, you know, where people who merge with the Lord. So it's not a good place for devotee.
Gop Kumar 他待的停留的地方呢，是 Sayujya Mukti。 就是融入主的存在，这种地方，所以最好不要待在这种地方。
Yeah, he said, you go to Mathura. Mathura is the most dear place, Lord Krishna's most dear place. You go there. That's your place.
Mathura 是主 Krishna 最亲爱的地方，他们告诉他，你最好去那里。
Actually, these people who had come from Vaikuntha, they'd come with the purpose to get Gop Kumar to go back to Braja, to go back to Vrindavan.
实际上, Vaikuntha的居民们, 来到这里就是为了让 Gopal Kumar 回到 Braja, 回到 Vrindavan.
Now Gop Kumar had come so far, such a long way from Vrindavan, from the Vrindavan on the earth planet, to come all the way up to this place of liberation, this Ayodhya Mukti place. So why should he want to go back to where he started from?
Gop Kumar, 他走了这么行了这么遥远的距离，才来到了解脱之地。 那为何呢？他现在又要回到他的初始地呢？
But Gop Kumar should remember that Vrindavan is not an ordinary place, but that is a favorite place of Lord Krishna. And by going there, then he will get all of his desires fulfilled.
Gop Kumar 应该始终铭记。 Vrindavan并非普通的地方，是主 Krishna 最喜爱的地方。他去了 Vrindavan， 他一切的愿望便会得到满足。Because
Gop Kumar is a devotee of Madan Mohan, Madan Gopal, so he'll go back to Vrindavan, and he'll be able to see Madan Gopal there in Vrindavan.
Gopal Kumar 是 Madan Mo。 马丹奴哈，马丹狗号的奉献者，他最好还是回文达文，在那里去见马丹狗号。So
Gop Kumar was very happy to hear this, and he offered his obeisances to the Vaikuntha people and to Lord Shiva and Lord Shiva's wife, and immediately he was taken back to Vrindavan.
Gop Kumar 听了他们这一番话，阿成。 内心感到十分的喜悦，便立即向外昆特的居民们以及主师傅和他的妻子顶拜。之后，他立即就回到了文达文。So
he found himself back on the earth planet again and in Vrindavan. So he just found a place to stay in the forest.
Vrindavan, 他就在一个森林里。 住了下来。
So, he was wandering around Vrindavan and he came to Mathura, and there he heard the Bhagavatam, and he was hearing the Brahmins also read from the scriptures. So he was able to, he followed, you know, he was in the forest initially, but he went on parikrama, and he followed the parikrama, and he came to Mathura, and he found the temple, nice temple there, and the Brahmins all there reading the scriptures.
参加了 parikram， 他就跟随着这个 parikram 绕拜，他来到了 Mathura， 一所非常精美的庙宇，在那里有一些婆罗门在诵读经典。So
the brahmanas were happy to teach him from the scriptures, to teach him what's taught in Srimad Bhagavatam, and to learn about how to do Bhagavat Bhakti.
这庙里的这些Brahmana就很高兴，教导Gopakumar经典，圣典Bodhyavatam，也教他，让他学习有关于Bhakti的知识。So
they taught him about performing the 9 different angas of Bhakti Yoga, beginning with hearing and chanting, and ending with becoming Krishna's friend and surrendering everything.
他们教导Gopakumar Bhakti的九个anga，九个分支，就是聆听、唱诵主的圣名，成为主的与主为友，向主臣服一切。
And yet he learned what is good for devotional service and what is not good, what things he needs to give up.
Gopakumar 也从他们那里学到了哪些是有利于履行奉献服务的，哪些是不利于奉献服务的，必须予以放弃。
So with all this knowledge he got from the Brahmins, he could more appreciate the association of the Holy Dham.
因为有了这些Brahmana的，通过这些知识，并且有了这些Brahmana的联谊，他便更加的欣赏能够待在圣地的这个益处。
So then he came to the forest. He came to after getting taught by the Brahmins. Then he went into the forest again, and when he went in the forest, then he met his spiritual master.
他原来是从森林里来的，当他被这些Brahmana教导了之后，他又返回了森林，而在森林他遇到自己的灵性导师。So Gopakumar,
seeing his spiritual master, he fell on the ground before him, offered his obeisances, and his spiritual master happily came and embraced him and gave his blessings.
Gopakumar, 便倒在地上，向他的灵性导师五体顶拜。他灵性导师非常高兴，就上前来拥抱了他，并且祝福了他。So
Gopakumar had been away to the higher planets. He'd been traveling to many places. He'd been away for a long time, but he saw that his spiritual master had not changed. So he could understand his spiritual master had a spiritual body.
Gopakumar 高等星宿不同的地方，离开了很久。但这一次他发现领导是没有丝毫的改变，于是他便觉悟到他领导是拥有的是一个灵性的身体。
Yeah, and he understood that his guru was an incarnation of Krishna.
他明白到他的 guru 是 Krishna 的化身。
And he had, and that his guru was also in a very special mood in Vrindavan.
他的 guru 也拥有就是 Vrindavan 的一种特殊心态。
So his spiritual master brought him through the different stages of devotional service.
他的 guru 就把 Gopakumar 带领 Gopakumar 经历了奉献服务的不同阶段。
And Gopakumar began to practice bhakti yoga without any interruption.
于是便毫不间断地开始修习 Bhakti Yoga 奉爱瑜伽。
So Gopakumar was very sincere and became very enthusiastic to follow the instructions of his guru with his guru present.
Gopakumar 便开始真诚热情地开始做奉爱服务，在他的灵性导师临在的情况下，在领导指导之下，真诚热情地做服务。
And very quickly, Gopakumar developed pure love of God, so much so that he lost all control of himself.
Gopakumar 他迅速地便获得了对神的爱，以至于他对自己的失去了对自己的控制。
And all Gopakumar could do was to chant the Lord, about the glories of the Supreme Lord.
Gopakumar, 现在此时此刻，他除了唱诵主世尊主的荣耀之外呢，他就完全专注于唱诵主的荣耀了。
Yeah, he would call out the holy name, O Krishna, O Govinda, O Mukunda, O Madhava.And he would call to Krishna that, please give me your favor, O Lord of Gopis, please deliver me.
Gopakumar 就开始呼唤圣名 O Krishna, O Govinda, O Mukunda, O Madhava. 他便呼在纯粹的爱当中呼唤Krishna, 请给我仁慈吧，牧牛姑娘的主人呐，拯救我吧。
So when he awakened this love for Krishna, he wasn't even able to perform, he wasn't able to properly worship the Lord anymore.
当他就这如此这番的唤醒了对神的纯粹之爱之后呢，他甚至无法恰当的崇拜主了。
So Gopakumar was chanting the holy name of the Lord. He had different favorite names. He would chant them again and again.
Gopakumar 便唱诵着主的圣名，并且一而再反反复复地唱诵着他最喜欢的名字。
So sometimes he would dance, and sometimes he would call out loudly, and sometimes he would cry.Became like a madman.
有时候他起舞，有时候他高呼主的圣名，有时候他哭泣，就像个疯子。
He would wander around. He forgot about everything. He forgot about his own body.
他会四处的漫游游荡，他甚至的忘记了自己，忘记了自己的躯体。
He would be asking, where are you now, my Lord? Where are you?
He 问你在哪儿，我的主啊，你在哪里？
Right, he was experiencing this mood of separation from the Lord. So one time, Gop Kumar described, he said, I thought I saw the Lord. I thought I saw him standing before me. And I ran to take hold of him, to touch him. But I became so overwhelmed, I felt fainted and fell to the ground. So Gop Kumar was really in ecstasy, in love of God. He was experiencing the highest level of devotional service. So it was at that moment that an airplane came from Vaikuntha with people on it, associates of the Lord, and they had come to take Gop Kumar with them to Vaikuntha. So they put Gop Kumar on the plane and they took him away, and when he opened his eyes, he saw everything was different again. So it was a shock for him, and it brought him out, it brought him back to full consciousness. He was no longer in the same state of mind as he was in Vrindavan when he was experiencing prema, and he saw the people before him. So because Gop Kumar had met the people from Vaikuntha before, so he had a desire to see Vaikuntha. So they were satisfying his desire by bringing him there. And the airplane which brought him to Vaikuntha is not like an ordinary airplane, very wonderful, indescribable. It had an effulgence that was more brilliant. It was like the sun. It was so brilliant. And it was made from the pure substance of the spiritual world. The airplane came from Vaikuntha, so it was not of the material world. It was coming from the spiritual world, and it was made with everything from the spiritual world.
And 因为它直接来自灵性世界，是用灵性世界的材料制成。
So the people from Vaikuntha, they embraced Gop Kumar and they told him, we will give you a body like ours. You know, people from Vaikuntha, they have a four-arm form. So they told Gop Kumar, we will give you a form like ours because you're coming to Vaikuntha. So you should have this form like us.
Vaikuntha 的这些居民们拥抱了 Gop Kumar.告诉他，我们会给你赐予一个跟我们一样的躯体，就是 Vaikuntha 的四臂形体，因为你来到了这里，你应该像我们一样也拥有这个躯体。
Yeah, they said, because you're coming to Vaikuntha, so you know that to have the form which you have just now with only two arms, you won't fully enjoy the Vaikuntha life. You need to have four arms. You should be like us.
他们就告诉格瓦库玛，你之前呢是两只手臂，那你没法享受百昆特的这种生活，所以你应该跟我们一样，也是有四只手，你才可以享受百昆特的生活。
And they told God, Kumar, you don't have to be so respectful to us. We are your friend. We're equals.
他们也告诉格瓦库玛。你不用对我们这么彬彬有礼，你是我们的朋友，应该是跟我们平辈。
But Gop Kumar wasn't interested. He didn't want that Vaikuntha form.
Gop Kumar 没有兴趣，他不想要 Vaikuntha 的四臂。
But his own body was actually from Govardhan. It became beautiful, like.The Vaikuntha people, because the Vaikuntha people, they had such beautiful features. So Gop Kumar from Govardhan, he also developed beauty like them.
Gop Kumar, he is from Govardhan Shan. So he is now also developing like
Right, so qualities like being eternal, fully spiritual, and very effulgent. So Gop Kumar's body became like that.
比如说像永恒灵性，充满光彩这种品质。
And the people of Vaikuntha, they all have mystic powers.So Gop Kumar was also given these mystic powers that he could do whatever he might want to do.
Vaikuntha 的居民都拥有玄秘力量。Gop Kumar 被赐予了玄秘力量，可以心想事成，可以想无实现自己的心愿。
So Gop Kumar traveled with them to Vaikuntha.And going to Vaikuntha, he saw all the coverings of the universe which he'd visited before. So these people.In the higher planets, they knew Gop Kumar, he had come there before. And so when they saw him going in the Vaikuntha aeroplane, they all glorified him and they were offering their pranams, their obeisances to him.
Vaikuntha, 高等行星宿的这些居民们都跟 Gop Kumar 很熟悉，认识他。当格瓦库玛乘坐着飞机去百昆的时候，高等星宿居民们开始荣耀他，向他献上顶礼，向他献上荣耀的祷文。
So right, when you go back to Godhead, you have to leave the material world, you have to go past all of these places.
回归神手的时候呢，也会离开物质世界的时候，也会经过所有这些高等星宿。
But this path, the road back to Godhead, is very blissful. It's not like a road in the material world. It's very blissful.
然而，这条回归神手的道路是非常喜乐的，喜乐迎人的，不像物质世界的那些道路。
So he passed through all these different places, and he passed through the coverings of the universe.
他就经过了所有这些地方，也穿越了宇宙的外壳。
So Gop Kumar was now, he was, you know, when he had first come there, he saw this, that he was passing over the different illusions of the material world. But now he was a bit more advanced, and he didn't think anything about liberation. He knew that liberation is not very important. And material attraction, he was interested before, but now he had no interest. So he was passing all the planets, and even Indra, king of heaven, he was offering his respects to Gop Kumar. So he was passing by, and people were shouting victory, and they were offering obeisances, worshipping him. And he passed also the abode of liberation, where he'd been before. And then he came to, after passing that place, he came to Lord Shiva's place, and he was able to offer his obeisances to Lord Shiva and Lord Shiva's wife. Lord Shiva was very nice to him, very blissful. He spoke with love and respect, glorified him. And then Lord Gop Kumar left Lord Shiva's place. He went on to Vaikuntha. Which is beyond the mind and beyond words. So when they got there to Vaikuntha, they told Gop Kumar, you have to wait here for a minute. We have to get permission for you to enter into this place. This is the procedure. you want to enter into Vaikuntha, you have to get special permission. You have to get permission from the Lord of Vaikuntha or from the authority. So, okay, so we'll go on from there next time to hear about what happens in Vaikuntha.
好，那今天我们讲到这里，下一节课我们聆听在百昆塔那里发生了什么事情。
Okay, are there any questions today?
我们看一下问题。第一个，问Gopinatha Priya Devadasi， 顶拜固的莲花族，有时候我们知道怎么做有利于奉献福，比如说遵守固的训示，但是自己心里还有自己的想法，就很矛盾。现在心意里很痛，请问怎么走出这种痛苦的境地呢？ Obeisance to Guru's lotus feet. Sometimes we know what's favorable for devotional service, for example, following the shiksha of Guru. But in our heart, we have all our own idea. We feel very, very contradictory. We are stuck in our mind. We feel painful. How can I walk out of this painful situation?
Well, we have to follow Sadhu Shastra and Guru.
If
you just follow your mind, well, whatever your mind is telling you, you have to confirm it with Sadhu Shastra and Guru. If you just follow your mind, you may get in trouble. The mind can be the friend, but the mind can also be the enemy. So, it's not wrong to use your mind and to think intelligently about what to do, but you have to support what you're doing, what your mind is telling you, with the proper authorities like Shastra and Sadhu Guru.
用心意是没有错误的，有智慧的运用心意，没有什么问题，但是要必须得到支持，得到权威，咕噜萨杜萨舍这些权威的认可。
So you can always confirm what you're doing with these authorities. Take the advice from them. Is it, you know, my mind tells me to do this, is it all right? You ask the authorities, get their sanction.
所以要永远得到咕噜萨杜萨舍的证实，你可以告诉他们，就是得到他们这些权威的建议，你可以跟他们说，我的心意是这样跟我说的，告诉我这件事，可不可以呢？ 要得到他们的批准。
Our mind, we have to understand our minds are not always so pure. It's not that we always have such pure thoughts in our mind, and we are often tempted towards sense gratification.
我们的心意它不总是纯净的，心意当中的想法并不是总是纯净的想法。
So you have to be careful not to just simply follow the mind without confirming what you're doing, that it's proper or not.
So you have to be careful.
Don't just serve your mind. Don't let your mind be the absolute authority. The mind should be working under the control of intelligence. And intelligence is seated next to the soul. The soul guides the intelligence, and use the intelligence to guide the mind. Okay. Any other?
下一个问题是来自 Pushpa Sarah Devadasi. 顶拜姑姑的莲花族，顶拜，请问 Gurudev 进入Vaikuntha跟解脱没有直接的关系吗？
Yeah. Okay, well, is there a difference between going into Vaikuntha and liberation?
Isn't there any direct relationship between entering into Vaikuntha and get liberation?
Well, liberation, when we speak of liberation, they often talk about impersonal liberation, which was just described. Gop Kumar went to the place of liberation, Sayujya Mukti. But higher than that place is the place of devotion.
Mukti. 但是比萨优杰目的更高的是做奉献服务的地方。Yeah.
In the place of liberation, there's no material suffering, but there's no actual engagement in devotional service.
在解脱的地方呢，已经不再有物质的痛苦了。
In the place of liberation, one is simply identifying with the Brahman, that we have become one, we've entered into the Brahman, the spiritual existence.
在这个解脱之地呢，我们认同于 Brahman。 认同于梵，就跟Brahman合一，成为一体了。我们就那个地方是灵性的存在，但是呢，我们就是变成了，就是我们就变成认同于Brahman了。
And there's no engagement in devotional service.
并且呢，在 那个地方，解脱之地，没有实实在在的奉献服务。So
that kind of liberation is never accepted by a devotee.
因此，这种解脱，奉献者是永远不会接受的。There
are actually five different kinds of liberation.
解脱有五种解脱。
So a devotee can accept four, But they cannot accept this one of becoming one, this place of sayujya, merging. They don't want that liberation. But the other kinds of liberation, they can go into Vaikuntha. They can accept that kind of liberation.
无种解脱当中，奉献者可以接受四其中的四种解脱，但是第五种就是萨优解目的，就是这种解脱是奉献者永远不接受的。奉献者会接受进入外昆塔这种解脱，他们可以接受。
Okay.
好，那下一个问题还是Pushpa Sara Devadasi的。我们现在做服务是灵魂做的吗？灵魂在睡觉，还没醒过来，还不知道与 Krishna 的关系。在没醒过来时候做服务是谁在做呢？ Is it that we are doing devotional service? Is the devotional service we are doing acted by the soul? Because my soul is sleeping, hasn't awakened yet, and doesn't know the relationship with Krishna. So who is doing the service?
Well, if you don't know your relationship with Krishna, and you say your soul is sleeping, then you must be acting in the bodily conception of life.
如果您不知道和Krishna之间的关系，而且灵魂还在睡觉的话，那您是在躯体的层面上活动的。
But of course, from the soul comes consciousness. You see, the soul is covered, right? Covered. So when we say "wake up, sleeping soul," yeah, we're sleeping because we've forgotten our relationship with Krishna. So we have to remember that. But it's not that the soul is not active. In the bodily concept of life, the soul is still there. But it's the pure consciousness is covered.
灵魂它有知觉，但是灵魂它被覆盖了。我们之所以说醒来吧，沉睡的灵魂，是因为灵魂忘记了与 Krishna 的关系，因此应当记住与 Krishna 的关。 所以当忘记了跟 Krishna 的关系的时候，并不是说灵魂没有活动，灵魂就不活动了，只是在躯体层面上活动。所以呢，应当在纯粹的知觉状态下活动，去除这种覆盖。
We're always active, the soul is always active. Just a question of where is the consciousness? Is the consciousness on the body or is the consciousness on the higher platform of Krishna?
灵魂是永远活跃的，问题就在于我们的知觉是在躯体层面呢，还是在知觉着Krishna的这个高等层面上呢？
So if we're not remembering Krishna, then we're controlled by the modes of nature.
如果我们没有记住 Krishna 的话，我们是受到物质自然形态的控制。The
modes of nature are causing us to act, to do different things.
物质自然形态导致我们去活动。 去做了不同各种各样的活动。
So try to cultivate the mode of goodness, keep away from the mode of passion and ignorance.
因此要努力培养善良属性，去除激情和愚昧属性的影响。
Okay.
下一个问题是来自于这位没有艺名的奉献者，在启迪的念珠上念诵和在没启迪的念珠上念诵有什么区别呢？
No, nothing really. There's not a big difference between chanting on beats which were given by the spiritual master and other beats, but the important point is the beats given by the spiritual master is it helps you to have some consciousness and remembrance of your connection with the spiritual master.
在就是您说到的这一点，在启迪念珠上和没启迪念珠上念诵没有很大的区别。但是呢，在启迪的念珠上念诵，它可以帮助我们，就是知觉，我们跟Guru的之间的联系。
Yeah, we think my spiritual master gave me these beads. My spiritual master chanted on these beads for me, and he gave these beads to me. And so it's very helpful for our consciousness when we're chanting.
我的灵性导师给了我这个念珠。我的灵性导师在这串念珠上念诵过，他为我念诵过。这个帮助我们在念诵的时候，有助于帮助我们念诵时候的知觉。
But you just chant on ordinary beads. Nobody, you just took them from somewhere. Spiritual master didn't chant on them. And so, you know, you can also chant. It's the same mantra you're chanting, but you know, you don't have quite the same absorption or quite the same thinking in relation to Guru.
在你普通的念珠上，古鲁没有念诵过的这念珠上念诵呢。当然了，念诵的曼陀罗是一样的，但是呢，我们的专注度不一样，然后我们的想法也不一样，就跟古鲁在So what about the relationship with Guru?
Well.That we're able to keep a strong connection with the Guru by remembering him, and by thinking of him and remembering how he gave us these beads and told us to chant on them. So we should try to keep the beads given by the spiritual master, keep them carefully.
So we should try to keep the beads given by the spiritual master, keep them carefully.
We should think these beads are for the rest of my life, for me to chant on.
要想着，这串念珠就是我这一生一辈子都要念诵的这串念珠。
Okay.
下一个问题，来自于 Rajendra Das， 感谢 Maharaj， 感谢 Hare Krishna。哦 ，sorry， 我漏了一个。如果启迪念珠丢了，该怎么念诵 ？If we lost this bead, so how can we chant?
Well, you have to get some more beads.
那你应该得到另一串念珠。
And if possible, you get your spiritual master to chant on them for you again.
如果可能的话，你就让你的灵性导师。就再一次为你在这另一串念珠上再念。好，那下一个问题是来自于老真的不，感谢 Maharaj 主持。从 瓦库马的亲身经历有个问题，一个奉献者原本地位在百昆塔，他想改变自己地位，渴望去格鲁卡，能否如愿以偿呢？又需要什么样的资格呢？ So from the experience of Gopakumar, I have a question. If a devotee has his original place in Vaikuntha, if he wants to change his position and aspire to go to Goloka, can he fulfill his desire? And what's the qualification?
Well, it's possible. We will see when Gop Kumar travels to Vaikuntha. We will hear about how it's possible to go to Goloka. The difference is that in Vaikuntha, the relationship with Krishna is more with awe and veneration, whereas in Vrindavan, there's more intimacy. In Vaikuntha, everyone is Dasyaras, the mood of servant to Krishna. But in Vrindavan, in Goloka, the higher rasas are there, the sakya, the friendship, the parenthood, the conjugal love, they're more prominent there in Vrindavan. But to go there, you have to develop the mood of spontaneous devotional service.
所以在格洛克文达问呢，有更高的rasa，比如说朋友情谊，还有父母的情怀和爱侣的情怀，这个这些更高的rasa呢占显著的地位，但是资格呢就是要去那里要发展自发的奉献服务。You
have to follow the mood of some of the great devotees. Just like you have to follow the mood of somebody like Nanda Maharaj or Mother Yashoda or the mood of a gopi and how they are serving Krishna. You have to cultivate thinking about their mood. Right, so this is called Raganuga Bhakti, that you follow in the footsteps of these great devotees. Then you can go into Goloka. But some people, they may be Vaikuntha Vasis, they may be residents of, they may not belong in Goloka. Their nature may be different. So they may be meant to be in Vaikuntha. Not everybody is meant to be in Goloka. Okay, have you any question more?
下一个问题来自于大庆的Sura，顶拜Gurudev，请问Gurudev。 这个月禁食牛奶，可以喝奶粉吗？
No.
Miss Man, 不可以。
No, you're not supposed to take milk powder. Well, at least you're not supposed to drink milk. What you can do, sometimes what you can do, you can take some custard. If you want to have milk, make yourself some custard. You get custard powder and put that in the milk and make it custard. In other words, you transform the milk. Then you can take it, but if you're not supposed to drink just milk.
So, let me check this word custard.
Oh, custard. Oh, well, you know, like corn flour or something. Corn powders, corn.
C-U-S-T-A-R-D.
Some people, they will put lemon in the milk and curdle the milk so that the milk becomes curd and whey.
凝结在一起了。
Yeah, you can drink the curd and whey. Don't drink the milk.
为什么不接受四比形体呢？感恩Gurudev。Why
did Gop Kumar not accept the form of the Vaikuntha people?
This is one question, and the other is Gop Kumar learned from those Brahmana and not learn from anybody else.
Yeah, so why did he learn from the Brahmanas and not from anybody else?
Yes. From when he left the forest.
Well, you want to hear the scriptures, you have to go to some place where people study the scriptures, where people are reading scriptures. You don't find many people reading scriptures. It's not very common. Usually it's only in the temple that people, you go there, you see the people there, they're reading scriptures.
如果小型学习经典的话，就要到那个人们朗读经典的地方去学习，并不是许多人朗读经典。 这个不是司空见惯的，就是你在庙里头才能见到那个朗读经典的景象。
The common people, they didn't have these scriptures before.
在以前普通人没有经典，
There was no Hare Krishna movement going around selling books everywhere. So very difficult to get to hear the scriptures anywhere. You have to go to temple to find them. And in the temple, you will find there will be brahmanas there who read the scriptures and who teach the scriptures, because that's their job. And why did Gop Kumar not accept the form of the Vaikuntha person?
Yes.
Because he's happy to be a person of Govardhan. He doesn't have the desire to have four arms. He likes to keep his identity as a cowherd boy of Govardhan. Okay. Well, material nature is under Krishna's control. Of course, Krishna has his directors. So, Maya, personification of Maya. Durga, Mother Durga is there. She is controlling. We don't surrender to Krishna, we surrender to Maya. If we're not under Krishna's control, then we're under Maya's control. Maya has her three modes of material nature to keep us entangled, to keep us busy.
Maya 有它的物质自然三属性, 让我们在里面忙个不停。 The next one, 方金利荣, 顶拜古 Maharaj, 人根据奉爱休息可以去百坤的或狗 Loka, 那我 我们真正的是灵性身份和主的关系是在哪个灵性星球呢？还是都有可能呢？Guru Maharaj, we can through spiritual practice we can go to Goloka or Vrindavan, but what's our real genuine spiritual identity and our relationship with Lord belongs to which planet, or is it it's possible both?
Both means?
Both means we can belong to Goloka and at the same time we can also we can have our spiritual identity both in Goloka and Vaikuntha, and we can have our relationship with Lord.Both in Goloka and Vaikuntha.
Oh, she's asking, is that possible?
Yes. So he's asking, is it possible? And he's asking, what's his spiritual identity and which spiritualplanet.
Well,
does he belong?
Okay, so we each have our spiritual identity and we have our spiritual, we have our relationship with Krishna according to that identity. Now,Some people, their relationship will be with Krishna in Vaikuntha, and some people, their relationship with Krishna may be in Goloka.
有的人他们是在 Vaikuntha 跟主拥有关系，还有的人是在 Goloka 与主拥有一种关系。
But whatever relationship we have,we will think that relationship is the best.
然而不管我们跟主有什么样的关系，我们都认为这种关系就是最好的关系。
That one may be in friendship with Krishna, and he thinks that being Krishna's friend is the most satisfying, it's the greatest pleasure,and he won't want to become a cowherd girl.
有的人跟 Krishna 是朋友关系，他就感到很满足了，并且他已经非常的快乐了，他已经感受到最大的快乐，他不想当一个牧牛女、牧牛姑娘。
So,Usually we will have, one may go to Goloka, but if his nature is not to be there, he won't be satisfied there, he won't be comfortable there, he'll want to go back to Vaikuntha.
可能一个人可以去 Goloka, 但是如果他的本性就是待在 Vaikuntha 的话，他即便去了 Goloka, 他也会感到不满意，也会在那里待得不自在、不舒服，他就想返回 Vaikuntha。
Just like the goddess of fortune, you know, she wants to dance the Rasa Lila. She wants to take part in Krishna's Rasa Lila. But she's the goddess of fortune, and it's not her nature to be like a cowherd girl.
正如幸运女神，她想参加到 Krishna 的 Rasa 之舞当中，但是幸运女神的，由于她作为幸运女神的本性天性的话，她就不可能成为一个牧牛姑娘。
She, the goddess of fortune belongs in Vaikuntha, and she's the consort of the Lord in Vaikuntha. She doesn't belong with the cowherd girls. You know, you can't take a queen, someone who's a queen, the goddess of fortune is like a queen, you can't put her in the village and tell her to make cow dung and cow patties, make cow dung, use the cow dung and make little cow patties and cook with the cow patties. You know, she can't do this kind of thing. She's not like a village woman. She's a goddess of fortune, so she's used to opulence and luxury and she's used to living in a certain way, very different from cowherd girls. So, difficult for us to understand the situation of the spiritual world in our conditioned state. But as we go on and read this book, we'll hear more. So just be patient as we go through the other chapters of this Srimad Brihad Bhagavad Amrita.
Just now, I listened to this Brihad Bhagavatamrita, and the level is so high, it's like a story. So how can I, although I cannot understand, how can I accept this truth in order to avoid doubt to the genuine of this the scripture, the truth of the scripture, avoid this doubt in my heart, because it's like a fairy tale.
Well, we have to accept that this story, this is coming from the pen of Sanatana Goswami. And Sanatana Goswami was a very dear devotee of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Sanatana Goswami is giving us the benefit of his realization and his study of the scriptures. He's presented all of this And remember, Lord Chaitanya taught him for 2 months. Lord Chaitanya met Sanatana Goswami in Benares, and he spent 2 months teaching him the science of Bhakti Yoga. And this is the first book which Sanatana Goswami wrote after he met with Lord Chaitanya.
Sanatana Goswami, he studied the texts, so he gave us the benefits of this book. And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Benares, in this
So we should have faith. We should understand it's very important. You know, we need to hear these things. We need to hear. Where else will we hear? You read the Krishna book, you read about Krishna dancing Rasa Leela with the gopis in Vrindavan. That's very high. That's higher than anything. You hear that? Why you can't hear this? You can be elevated by taking part in Sankirtan, the chanting of the holy name. This is the recommended process. Do Sankirtan, chant the holy name, join the devotees in the Sankirtan movement, become attracted to the Sankirtan, and take part in the Kirtan, and then you will feel the highest happiness, the greatest spiritual ecstasy. So, you have to follow the process. You want initiation, you have to take the disciple course, and then you have to get recommendation from the local authority, and then you have to approach a spiritual teacher and request him.
You 经过考试，并且得到当地的权威的推荐，然后您去找灵运导师恳求得到启迪。
Spiritual masters not anxious to accept disciples. He's not going looking, canvassing, come and take initiation from me. It's up to you. You have to come yourself and beg. Give me initiation. I want initiation. But you have to be qualified.
灵性导师并不是焦虑的渴望接受门徒。并且到处的去找寻找门徒，说服来接受我的启迪吧，并不是的。您得去主动的去，这取决于启迪不启迪，取决于您本人。您得去来到灵性导师面前呢，来找灵性导师恳求灵性导师，我想启迪，我想得到您的启迪。与此同时，您自己还得具备资格。
Previously, you didn't want initiation. So many other people came after you, they got initiation. But you didn't want initiation. Now you want initiation. Now you have to go through the process and try to get initiation. It's important.
在此之前，您不想起迪，而在您就是在您后面的人，他们都起迪了。那现在呢，您又想起迪了，所以呢，您就得要去经过这些程序。起迪很重要。好的。The next one. Siddharani Devadasi, 顶拜孤儒，顶拜奉献者们，如果梦到圣人和奉献者们在听课，是真实的还是梦啊？
Well, they say that if you dream about the spiritual master, that's real.
他们说，如果您梦到灵性导师，是那就是真实。
I don't know. It depends what you were dreaming. We have to hear about your dreams, and I have to see what's happening in your dream.
我不是，我们得听一听您的梦到底是什么，看看您梦到的是什么。The next one.
Yeah.
下一个来自陈冠江 Chaitanya Charan Das Hare Krishna 顶拜 Gurudev 在佛家梵歌 13.8 至12世纪有人说所有知识的基础是谦卑因为知识的开端是谦卑有人说知识的基础是灵性导师因为灵性导师重要还有人说为主昆士纳做服务，因为做服务可以发展起所有的知识。到底所有知识的基础是什么？为什么？请教咕噜确认一下。Hare Krishna Vaisnava Gurudev. In Bhagavad Gita 13:8-12 verse, somebody said it's humble.This is the basis of all knowledge because knowledge begins with humbleness. Somebody else says the spiritual master is the most important. It's the basis of knowledge is spiritual master because spiritual master is most important. And somebody else says devotional service for Lord Krishna becauseby doing service, we can develop all knowledge. So, my question is, Indeed, what's the basis of all knowledge and the reason why? So this, I want to beg a guru to confirm to me.
So, from the verse you mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna is describing the process of knowledge.
就是知识的程序。
So I think he's mentioned about 20 items of knowledge. The first one is amanitvam adamvitvam, being humble and without pride.
所以就提到了二十种，二十个，有二十个元素，就是知识的二十个元素。第一，这个呢就是谦卑勿傲。If
you're not humble and if you're proud, you won't come and take initiation. You have to be humble and without pride in order to accept initiation.
如果是怀着骄傲之情的话，那是不可不会主动的去接受启迪的。想要接受启迪，必须要谦卑勿傲。
Then of course, you need also a spiritual, you need to accept a spiritual master. That's also part of the process of knowledge.
也要接受一位灵guru，灵领导师，这也是这个方程序的，就知识的这个程序的一部分。
So the spiritual master is going to give spiritual knowledge. It's up to the devotee to take advantage of the teaching and the message of the spiritual teacher.
所以呢，就是取决于这个奉献者，他要从灵性导师那里接受知识，从灵性导师那里接受教导。And
he's going to teach, he's going to give instructions to engage you in devotional service.
其后呢，就灵性导师就会给予训示，让人从事于使人们从事于奉献服务。So
we have to perform our service pure, unalloyed devotional service.
因此，我们必须要履行纯洁无瑕的奉爱服务。So
they're all part of the process of knowledge.
因此，他们都是知识的部分。We
cannot say only have the guru, we cannot say only do devotional service, we cannot say only be humble. It's all they're all together. It's all part of the process of bhakti yoga.
奉爱瑜伽Bhakti Yoga的一部分。
Just like you have a right hand, you have a left hand, you have a right leg, you have a left leg, you know, they're all parts of the body, they all work together.
正如您有右手，还有左手，有右腿，还有左腿，他们都是躯体的构成躯干的一部分。
So you're asking where does the which is the basis of the knowledge? They're all part of the basis of knowledge. It's all part of the process.
您问到，哪一个是所有知识的基础？回答就是，他们都是知识的一部分，他们都是这个程序的一部分。
Okay.
下一个问题 ，Pancha Tatva Das， 迪麦 Maharaj 和所有的奉献者，我们没见到主，只见到主的奉献者，哪个更重要呢？见到主和见到奉献者。
There's no diff. There's Ruha.
Yeah, there are following.
I only met the devotees.
看到。
哦，如果看到什么？
如何看到这种情况？有些奉献者说，他们见到 Krishna 和 Krishna 交流啊。有些奉献者说，他们见到了 Krishna。并且跟 Krishna 交流了，但是呢，他们却不跟灵性导师和奉献者联谊，怎么对待这种情况呢？
Okay, so, yeah, seeing the spirit, seeing the devotees is as good as seeing Krishna. If the devotees are pure devotees, if the devotees are acting properly, then they're as good as Krishna. They represent Krishna.
见到 Krishna 是一样的。如果这名纯粹奉献者，他是在正确的活动当中，那么这名纯粹奉献者就跟主 Krishna 一样，他代表了主 Krishna。
So somebody says that they saw Krishna, and they see Krishna. How should we deal with these kind of people? So Krishna,
Somebody claim they have seen Krishna and have interaction with Krishna, but they don't associate with guru and devotee.
Yeah. Okay, so Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita who he reveals and who he associates with, who he sees. Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Tejam satata yuktanam bhajatam pratipurvakam dadami buddhi yogam tam yenamam upayanti te. To those who are constantly devoted to me and worship me with love, then I give the understanding by which they can come to me. So Krishna associates with people who are constantly devoted to him.
Krishna 在《博迦梵歌》当中揭示了他和什么样的人联谊，并且向什么样的人揭示他自己。就在这个世界当中，就说到对那些恒常的怀着奉爱崇拜我的人，我给予他们理解力，使他们来到我面前。因此答案就是，对那些恒常的奉爱的人，于是呢会揭示他自己，给予他的联谊。
So somebody doesn't come and associate with devotees, that's their own misfortune. They don't like that. But they say they see Krishna. So we have to see how much are they devoted. Are they really devoted to Krishna? We have to see how much are they engaged in Krishna's service? And when they see Krishna, how do they greet Krishna? Do they offer prayers to Krishna?
When they see Krishna, how do they welcome Krishna? Do they offer prayers to Krishna?
We see all the other people when they meet Krishna, even Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva and other great devotees, they, when they meet Krishna, they will offer prayers to Krishna. So, we have to see how much are they actually you know, how much they're qualified to be with Krishna. So we encourage them that they should try to come and hear. But if they're not inclined to associate with devotees, it's not a very good sign. Well, it can be mixed devotional service. It can be just like in Srimad Bhagavatam, in the third canto, I think it's chapter 28, describes devotional service in the mode of passion, and devotional service in the mode of goodness, devotional service in the mode of ignorance. So, devotional service, although we're performing devotional activities, they can be influenced by the modes of nature. So that is mixed devotional service.
那么就是混是混杂的奉献服务，在圣典伯伽瓦坛第三篇，我想是28章，就谈到了激情形态、善良形态和愚昧属性的奉献服务。这尽管他们在从事着这些服务，然而他们是受到
Just like one may be worshipping the deity, but he still may be influenced by the modes of nature. So that is mixed devotional service.
比如说一个人，一个被奉献者在崇拜着神像，但是呢，他却受到物质自然形态的影响。
But somebody is doing pure devotional service. Bhagavad Gita describes Mahatmanas tu mam parta daivim prakritim ashritya, that the great souls are under the protection of the divine energy.
纯粹奉爱服务的伯伽梵歌就是用这个诗节描述那些伟大的灵魂们，他们在神圣能量的保护之下。
So that Daivi Prakriti, Krishna said that under his divine energy, this is personified by Srimati Radharani. When we engage in devotional service, then we are under the direction of Srimati Radharani.
Radharani的人格，因此从事这样的奉献服务的呢，是在 Radharani 的直接的指导之下的。
Right? We offer our service to Srimati Radharani, Radharani offers to Krishna.
我们把服务供奉给Krishna。
But if one is in the mode of passion and goodness or ignorance, then that's mixed devotional service. It's not pure devotional service.
如果呢，它是在激情、善良、愚昧属性下的影响下的奉献服务是混杂的，它不属于纯粹的奉献服务了。
And if you're just doing ordinary mundane material activities, then it's not devotional service at all. It's just karma.
如果您是做的是普通的受到污染的世俗活动的话，那根本就不是奉献服务，那它是 karma 因果业报。
And we hope it's not vikarma. Vikarma means sinful activities.
我们希望，这种活动不是 vikarma. Vikarma 意思是罪恶的。
Mm-hmm. Okay.
没有问题了。Hare
Krishna, good day. 因为现在已经超过九点了，我们还有最后一个问题，我没有发上来。我想问您是留到下次课回答，还是今天回答？今天，如果只有一个问题，今天可以。好的，那我发上来。
问题来自阿米，请教咕噜，我已经上完门徒课了，也突壁了咕噜，您是否就等待您的应允，并接受启迪呢？期待中，因为启迪是奉献瑜伽的开始，但现在咕噜没法来中国，我们也无法去印度，这是个问题。
No, it's not a problem, but you have to wait. You don't get initiation immediately. There's a waiting time. After you take shelter, you have to wait for some time. And you have to wait until the local authorities are ready to approve you for initiation. So first you take shelter, and then you have to wait at least 6 months, because there has to be some testing period between the teacher and the disciple. Not that immediately you get initiation, but whatever service you're doing just now, it's not lost. You'll get the benefit of that. Don't think you're wasting your time, but it's better to be safe than to be sorry. If you go too quick and later on then you regret, then it's not good. 就马上就要必须立刻启迪的，但是您的服务没有任何损失，仍然会有好处的，并不是浪费时间，所以最好还是安全起见，那不要操之过急，那否则的话后悔就不好了，反悔就不好了。Initiation can be done without being together. Although you're in China and I'm in India, you may not come to India, I may not go to China, but still you can be initiated by communication, by telecom, or even by letter, you can be initiated.
启迪并不需要就是一在一起 印度，我也去不了中国，但是可以通过交流，可以通过 telecom， you mean
Wi-Fi？
Wi-Fi OK， 可以通过就是这种微信的沟通啊，或者是就是网上，或者是通过信件也可以提的。
And so it's not a wasted time to wait.
所以等候也不是什么浪费时间。
You're getting the benefit of whatever service you're doing now. It will be, it's all going to come to your credit.
无论您现在从事什么样的好处，您都从什么服务都能得到好处，都会就是被记入您的灵性账户的。
Okay, so don't worry.Sometimes we have experienced some people in the beginning, they're very eager to get initiation, then after they get the initiation, then they're not so enthusiastic anymore.
We have this experience. Some people, when they first get initiated, they're not so enthusiastic anymore. But when they get initiated, they're not so enthusiastic anymore.
So we're very cautious.
所以我们是很谨慎小心的。
不用怕，一分钱一分货。
不用怕，
You get what you pay for. You spend more time, it's more valuable.
所以，你得到的就是你付出的，你花了更多的时间。
Okay.
So this Mara, she answered that got your point, Mara.
Oh.
感恩感恩再再感恩咕噜。
谢谢 Amy. 感谢 Amy. Okay, Hare Krishna. 早上好。Sati.
Hare Krishna. 好的。感恩咕噜的精彩讲课和对这么多问题的耐心的解答，也非常感谢咕噜妈你们的解答。那我们今天早课就到这里了，咕噜。
Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki jai,
jai.
Hare Krishna.